Hello and welcome to the Skit Twins podcast.
Is this supposed to be French?
I don't know.
I could be totally French. I am practically French.
Why are you? How are you practically French?
I did French for 18 years of my life.
18? What?
I still do French, technically. I use Duolingo on a daily basis. I'm on a 300-day streak.
300?
Yeah, and any time I've missed it, I've only missed it one day.
So you're able to, like...
I can tell you all about my family. I can tell you about work.
Right, speak some French.
Bonjour mes petits amis. Comment ça va, moi? Ça va bien, merci beaucoup. Où est le gars? J'ai deux frères et une sœur jumelle. Elle s'appelle Judith. Je n'ai pas de travail parce que je suis une athlète.
Okay, well done. Fair do.
If you can translate that, go you. If you can't, sorry, but I can't remember what I said, so I can't translate it.
You asked where the train station was.
Oh, I also said I have two brothers and a twin sister. So, how are you?
Good to hear.
Fantastic. Or alternatively,
that's really rubbish.
I hope things get better. Yeah. Hope you're good. Hope this podcast finds you well. If it does, give yourself a pat on the back. If not, give yourself a pat on the back anyway, because you're listening to a podcast and that should hopefully maybe make you feel better.
Sorry, I'm not being very talkative because I'm looking for a good GIF to reply to Susan.
Okay. Is it GIF or GIF?
GIF.
You sure?
Yep.
I like to play devil's advocate a lot and just start arguments. Like if everybody is in like consensus with, yeah, it's GIF, I'll just be like, I think it's GIF.
Just to wind people up a little bit.
Like, I'm just that kind of person. It's okay, though, because Rev Keith's like that, too.
Rev Keith is class.
I mean, obviously, I'll not go against the Bible, but, like, I mean, I'd do it just to get a bit of conversation going if things are getting tight.
Dare you, Bible study this week. I want you to stir the pot,
lads. What if Moses didn't exist?
No, I want you to turn around. Please, can you just lean forward at some stage whenever it's slightly quiet and just go, what if we're wrong?
I've done that before, have I not?
Not a church Bible study, but I think it would be really funny. Just but then just give Keith a wee wink, wee nod.
Keith, you sit back out of this. I want to hear the people.
Imagine Mum's reaction. She would go mad. She would be like, Chloe,
what if Islam is the way to go instead of Christianity? I mean, it could be, to be fair. Like, I'm happy enough with my faith. Like, you know, I'll be dead by the time I find out. So, if I've lived my life believing the wrong thing, fair enough, I'm happy doing it.
Fair play. Right, what have we been up to since the last time we did a... podcast?
We did a talk about South Africa and we didn't record it.
We did. We should see if they have the CD.
Yeah. We have a CD ministry in our church where they record the service and send it out to people who can't make it to church.
It's pretty good.
Should definitely make it into a podcast.
They should. Loads of churches do that.
Yeah.
How many people would listen to our church's podcast? I would.
1.5 speed. There we go, Keith.
Just sit in an actual church. Keith, could you... talk a wee bit faster. It's weird. I find that whenever I listen to the radio, although now I've started listening to podcasts in normal speed again just so that they last longer. Chloe has her rock.
How is my rock wet on the bottom? How did that happen?
Because it's mold, because you licked it and it has bacteria from your mouth.
Oh, imagine. Just a wee cesspool of bacteria.
You licked it again.
I did. I licked the bacteria ridden bit.
Anyway, I've been listening to podcasts again on normal speed, and at the start it was weird because it felt like everyone was talking really slowly.
But then now you go on to 1.5 and you're like,
it's scary.
Like, I've been over the, like, in the gym and stuff, I'll listen to it at normal speed, but like whenever I listen to podcasts at home, I'll listen it on like 1.5 or 2, mainly just because I have so many podcasts.
I've just started deleting ones.
I've been hanging with the Haggerty's and stuff like that. I've just had to delete them. I listened to the odd one, but yeah, I've just had to be like, Gotta trim it down here.
Yeah.
I've got over 6,000 podcasts.
Gee whiz.
I don't even know if that's probably a lie.
But yeah, I actually counted and I was like, gee whiz, Paddy.
But
that's about it. Training and talking about South Africa.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not a bad life, innit?
We had a karate thing with a proper Team Ireland karate coach.
Oh yeah, that was terrifying.
Yeah. Like, I like karate, but I'm not good at it. Like,
yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, I like kata and stuff because I know that I can slowly improve on that. Whereas fighting and stuff, I'm just like, I have absolutely no idea what I'm doing.
I just feel so bad.
Yeah. But, I mean, maybe that's more of a reason to work at it, to become better.
Yeah.
And maybe I'm just sort of being lazy and just being like, ah, no, it's too hard.
Let's become better at fighting. Let's just become quicker on our feet.
Yeah, we need to put some speed work into
we can just like...
I'm going to take off my jacket.
Whip someone's butt.
I like whipping butt. I hope people heard my jacket fall to the floor there. Was just my jacket. Stop.
Why are you standing here naked, Judith? It's weird.
I'm not.
Please put some clothes on.
Chloe, you're making it weird. You're making it weird.
You're the one who's strapped on. Chloe. She didn't. We're both naked. But these people wouldn't know. We're not. I have clothes on. See, this is me. If I was like doing this on my bare skin, you'd like definitely, it would sound different. But yeah, it would sound like that. That's just slapping my cheeks. My face cheeks. Just move on quickly. Say something. Judith, I made it weird. Judith,
you made it
say
so
words.
You made it so
say words.
So weird.
Just say words.
It's almost Christmas. It's 31 sleeps till Christmas.
31 sleeps till Christmas. I love Christmas.
I always decide that I'm allowed to start getting...
Oh, here, no. You know what we should talk about before?
What?
I flippin' sliced my finger open on an electric carving knife. That's what I did today. Yeah. Anyway, 31 sleeps till Christmas. On you go.
I'm only allowed to
get... Onwards.
I'm only excited. I'm only allowed to... Take a breath. Start again.
Is that a thing they learn in acting? I think it is, yeah, isn't it?
I'm only allowed to get excited whenever it's 30 sleeps until Christmas.
So you're only allowed to start getting excited tomorrow?
Yeah.
I'm gonna wake you up and just be like, just hear those sleigh bells jingling, ring ting ting.
No, I'm just allowed to... I'm allowed to start, planning Christmas, but as soon as December 1st hits, that's whenever I'm going full Christmas mode.
We still need to get an advent calendar.
Yeah. I want the Where's Wally one again this year from Marks and Spencer's, but I also want, like, a nice one. And I'm not saying that Marks and Spencer's chocolate isn't nice, but, like, you know what I mean? Like, a nice one.
I want a Milky Bar one.
I want either Milky Bar or dark chocolate.
I want a Milky Bar one.
Milky Bar one.
Milky Bar.
I wish they did Milky Way ones.
And they do Mars ones. It's just, like, the Mars chocolate. Like, you don't get a Mars bar again.
I want, like, a Milky Way one. But, like, just with the inside bit of Milky Way. Like, you just open the door and you just peel out that, like, white nougat-y stuff. Just put it in your face. Well, maybe, I don't know, maybe they could wrap it up.
Yeah.
But I like the idea of just scooping it out.
Well, that would be a waste if, like, you set it somewhere or it just, like, it melted.
I mean, that's your own fault. Hard lessons learned in life.
Sticky. You just have to keep it in the fridge, wouldn't you?
Yeah. Imagine a milk one. Just chocolate milk shots every day. Oh, unreal. Think of the calcium.
Is that how you'd sell it?
Yeah.
I need to see the advert now. Mummy, it's the 2nd of December. Can I get my calcium-filled advent calendar?
Yes, you can.
I love this chocolate milk advent calendar. Not only is it chocolatey, it also gives me calcium.
Dale Farm chocolate shot advent calendar.
All the kids at the end, shot, 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 shots.
Chocolate milk shots, kids.
We cow dressed up.
No, start off right and it's, Mummy, can I get an advent calendar? No, you don't need all that sugary chocolate for your face. And then it's like the wee cow walks in and it's like, hey, kids. Do you want an advent calendar, but your parents say there's too much sugar?
Yeah!
Do you like milk?
No. I like chocolate.
Well, here's something even better. It's chocolate milk. Sorry, right, let's move on. We're going too far into this.
Expect to see those on your shelves, though, within the next 16 years.
Also, my buddy bra idea, where you bump boobs with your friend and your bras light up. Also available... buddy butt bounce boxers.
Buddy butt bounce boxers.
Yeah, you gotta get the male market in there too. Buddy bro bounce boxers.
Yeah, bro bounce.
Bro bounce. And then you like bump butts and then your boxers play a tune.
What tune?
Friends. Eye of the tiger. It has to be manly.
I mean, true, but. Yeah.
Yeah. Christmas 2032. Be there.
That's not 16 years away.
Yeah, I know. But the advent calendar thing is 16 years away. The other one is...
How many years away is 2032, Judith?
13.
Fair play.
Did I do it?
That was stressful.
Stressful maths. Was stressful maths. Here, Stuart the organist tried to explain music theory to me and my brain fell out of my ears. We were carrying on. I was mucking about in the group chat we have, the music group chat, and then he came in today and he was like, what key have I got these in? And then he was like looking through the keys and I was like, Stuart, just stop, okay? I can play it. That's all we need to know here. And then he was going through it. He was like, oh yeah, that's F major, that's G sharp major. I was like... Are you okay? And I was like, it's just about the sharps and flats. And he was like, yeah, it is. And then I was like, yeah, so it's about the scales and stuff. And he's like, yeah, but there's also these wee rhymes that makes it really easy to remember. Can't remember the rhymes, Stuart. Not that easy to remember, actually. But yeah, musical theory is not my forte.
Oh, that's kind of like a musical joke. Ha ha
ha. I want one of those light up penguin thingies from Marks and Spencer, and it looks like an ice sculpture, but there's a light in the bottom, so the whole thing lights up. I used to have a polar bear, but I gave it away as a present because I thought my friend would appreciate it more. How selfless am I? Chloe's just caught a penguin in her entire mouth.
I'm saving the penguins.
Why?
It's real cool in my mouth. I say cool things all the time.
Well, then say some cool things. You need to save those penguins.
Ice cubes.
Yep.
Igloos.
Mm-hmm.
Anti-global warming.
Anti-global warming.
Global cooling.
Global cooling. Global warming is incorrect, though. What do we call it, Chloe?
The greenhouse effect.
Chloe, we call it climate change.
Okay.
Because the climates change. Some places become hotter. Some places become colder.
Yeah, but
some places become stormier.
You could call it global warming and global cooling and global wetting and global drying
and global windying.
Except you can't call it global because storming. It's not global.
Yeah.
Global changing.
Yeah. Climate changing.
Global climate change.
Global climate change. That's what we'll go with. We also cleaned Susan, our dog, not the human.
Susan, 10 and 2.
Oh. Hands on the wheel, eyes on the road. Oh no, I did it the wrong way. You're meant to say eyes on the wheel, hands on the road. Oh,
it's
I'm
a
out.
Funny joke we do at home. Daddy always says it, but he doesn't say it to us because we don't drive.
That makes me... I've got really annoyed about that the past week. I've sort of been like, oh, if I could just drive.
And then like the thought of self-driving cars, that's sort of going backwards, isn't it? Because is it Tesla? Oh no, that was just their shatterproof glass. Shattered.
Oh, I wasn't aware of this. What?
They were like going to introduce like this new shatterproof glass that didn't like smash in an accident, and then they were showing it and the glass kind of smashed.
You know the way shatterproof glass is like Or is it shatter resist?
Shatter resist.
Yeah.
The stuff, and it breaks, but it just goes into like a million tiny, tiny pieces.
Yeah.
What's that called? Shatterproof or shatter resistant? Or?
Shatter resistant? I don't know. Because like...
I know that whatever it was called, it always confused me because I was like, well, it clearly still breaks.
Well, no, shatter resistant, like shatter resistant rulers just snap in half. They don't like...
Yeah, that's true. That's true. They were cool, but they flippin' hurt if you broke them. Like, if you were holding it and it broke on your hand, like, it stung.
Duh, it was also, two pieces of plastic. It was like someone flicking you in the head.
Yeah.
Really hurt.
It was like two tectonic plates. Also, if someone slapped you with them in the arm, you knew about it.
The flexible rulers, though.
They were, oh, they were like wee whips.
Yep.
Yeah. Also, there was times when you could, like, bend them out of shape and then they never went straight again.
Nah, like, it just took time. Like, mine went really out of shape and then I just put it in, like, underneath a book for, like, 2 weeks.
I was going to say, are they not the things and you put them in, like, boiling water or whatever? Or is it freezing? You put them in boiling water and then cold water and then water, it straightens out. I'd like to get one and just try that and see if there's any actual way to straighten it really quickly. But then what's the point? Because you put it in your bag and it bends again. I've just sort of lost all idea of what the concept of those rulers were.
It was cool. It was a way of making money.
Fair. They were like £1 in Woolworths.
Yeah.
Woolworths.
I think I had two. I want to find it.
You had a pink one and a clear one.
No, I just had a clear one. I don't think I had a pink one.
Oh. So you had two clear ones?
Yeah.
I had a purple one.
Maybe I did have a pink one and the Woolworths was like wibbly wobbly, if that makes sense. Like and then I know the clear one, it was just written straight. Woolworths.
I know I had a purple one.
Yeah.
Because purple was my favourite colour for a while because red and blue were both my favourite colours. So then I just merged them into purple.
You're just like, yeah, purple's good.
I was like, I need to pick one of these. Why have one when I can have both?
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Hannah.
Hannah who?
Hannah Partridge in a pear tree.
Chloe, what's the difference between a joke and a rhetorical question? No, really, I wanted to know.
A joke is funny and a rhetorical question doesn't need an answer.
Ah, fair.
Got a really bad thesaurus the other day. Didn't work very well. It was terrible. Also terrible.
No, is it not? Not only was it terrible, it was also terrible.
Terrible jokes.
I really like really bad jokes. If you have any good jokes, guys, send them my way because I will appreciate them no matter how terrible they are.
Judith, how can they send them your way?
Plug our social media. Okay. I thought this was another joke. I was like waiting for the punchline. You can tweet me, us, at skit underscore twins. I was trying to do like you can tweet us at, and then I was doing like the at sign because the start of the username is the at sign. So you can tweet us at skit underscore twins. That's skit underscore twins.
Or skit underslash twins.
Yeah, you can call it underslash if you want to. If you're not familiar with this joke, go back and listen to old podcasts.
Still trying they're to make all it a
of,
thing.
They're all available on YouTube, even if they're not available on SoundCloud or iTunes. So, yeah. You can also, we're also on Instagram with the same username. You can search us on YouTube, just Skit Twins, and Facebook. You should be able to find us if you just search Skit Twins.
Thank you very much.
You can also email us at skit.twins@gmail.com.
Thanks for your enunciation.
Yep, you're welcome.
It was fantastic.
Fantastic.
Stop it.
Stop it.
That's not nice.
That's not nice.
I'm just going to bash you with my stone.
Yeah. That's terrifying.
I have a stone. I'm not afraid to use it.
Please don't use it.
You know what's weird?
What?
Glass.
Glass. Why?
Yeah. Like, it can be... Like, it starts off as a liquid and it's, like, bright red, but then it cools down and it's clear. And then just sometimes glass is invisible.
What, whenever it's really, really clean?
Yeah.
That is kind of weird. Like, how does it work?
Glasses are weird too. Like, just glasses in general. Like, they're just bits of glass that help you see.
I know, but like, sunglasses seem like they're the same thickness as other glasses. But you look through them and like, one's more magnifying than the other. And it's kind of like, oh, this is trippy.
Yeah, but also like, the way glasses are made, like, it's not just glass. Like, they curve. Like, there's a specific curve in them.
That's because of your cornea.
Retina? Lens?
Lens. Eye. Lens. You can have a...
Concave.
Concave or convex lens.
Yeah.
I remember GCSE biology. Yes.
My biology teacher convinced me to do it for A-level. He was a liar. He was like, you're good at biology, Judith. You're great at biology. You will love A-level biology and... Never believe teachers when they tell you that, unless they're geography teachers.
My geography teacher was buzzing whenever I said I was doing geography for A-level. She was like, yeah, Chloe, you can do it. And then I was like, I just hope I don't have you.
Civil.
No, I wasn't even that. I just didn't like my class. They were just terrible.
That was GCSE that I wasn't sure I was going to do geography for. And then my teacher was like properly came over and spoke to me after class and was like, Judith, you are good at geography. And I was like, oh. Okay. Maybe I
don't like confrontation. I'll do your subject.
Maybe that's what it was. It was like, oh, please stop talking to me. Okay, I'll do your subject. Thank you. Bye. I don't regret it though. Thank you, Dr. Vogel, for making me do geography.
I did additional maths and I'm really glad that I did it. I didn't like it, but I liked my teacher and therefore I liked it. And like, Mr. Moana, you were class. You were real nice.
Aww.
He was adorable.
I really wish I'd had him as a teacher, and I think I would have done better in GCSE maths if I had Mr. Bogle for maths, because he was scary, but also really good teacher.
No, I think Mr. Bogle was one of those teachers that he was scary for the first couple of weeks, and then you sort of knew where you stood.
Yeah, I think if I had him for GCSE, I might have cried, and then maybe he would have been like, Judith, it's gonna be okay. I'd have been like, okay, and then I would have been fine.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Like, I would have had a breakdown at the start and then I would have picked myself up and I would have been great.
Judith, you did too good.
My GCSE was an entire... My GCSE maths with the teacher I had was an entire breakdown.
Mine was just... I don't know how to describe it, because Mr. Moaning was just... He was so nice and he didn't shout, he didn't raise his voice, and yet you still felt awful if you did bad. Or like if you did something wrong, you just felt awful because he just sort of came over and he was like, now Chloe... Really? 60%? That's... You can do better than
me,
that.
Me, I would have been flying as high as a kite if I got 60% in maths.
You can do better than 60%.
That's like, adorable.
I know. I don't get simultaneous equations. I did, actually. That was one of the things I actually did get.
I really liked simultaneous equations. Yeah. I liked algebra and triangles. But I think it was because in my head I was like, oh, there's letters there.
It's English.
It's English. It's not maths. I really do think it was. I think it was all mental, but I wasn't like the worst in my class, but I also like wasn't.
Oh, I think
like,
I was
the top,
I think I was the worst in my class. I think I'm pretty sure I was the worst in my class.
But I was like bottom set of maths. And then I think, oh wait, no, maybe I wasn't.
No, you weren't, because you still got to do higher tier maths.
I did, yeah.
The bottom sets. I had to do lower tier.
I must have been like the bottom of the higher then.
But then, was it third year we were streamed in maths and French?
Yeah. I was bottom in that year because I should have been in a higher class for French, but because I was bottom tier maths, I could only be like the second bottom for French, and it was horrendous. Like, I'm not saying I was fantastic at French, and I definitely wasn't like top of the class, but I was... I was just like, this is awful. How do you not know how to pronounce chien? Dog.
Who did I have?
Le chat.
In
cat.
Third year French.
I had Miss Allen.
Did I have Mr. Sampson that year? I don't think I did.
Miss Mills. I think you had Miss Mills because I had her for German. You must have had her for French.
Oh, maybe, yeah.
She was quite a good German teacher, in fairness. I just didn't like German. So I was just... I got to a stage... That was the same thing that happened in biology. I got to a stage and I was like, I'm out. I'm not even keeping this up next year. I don't care.
That was like me in Spanish, and I got the highest grade I ever got in Spanish whenever I gave up. I was just like, you know what? I'm going to go into this Spanish oral and just try my best.
I can't even remember my
German. I think I used French in it.
I can't remember my German oral at all. I remember sitting there and looking at her and she was smiling at me encouragingly and I was like, I am pretty sure I just...
Shut up, my Spanish teacher hated me. Both of them did. They just did not like me. And I was like, what have I done to deserve this?
Did you have two Spanish teachers?
Yeah, for second year at least. And third year, I just had the one. But like, I don't know, I just never spoke in Spanish and then she just took a wild disliking to it.
Aww.
Okay. I guess because I couldn't see the board and she was just like, oh, I have to get this away in some printouts again.
That was me.
Oh, my days.
That was me in P1 with Miss Hamilton. I mean, I'm sure she was lovely, but my memory of her is her shouting at me and sending me to the back of the classroom so she could read out what was on the board, and I was in tears. I don't want to go to school anymore.
That was also me in AS level chemistry. My teacher just didn't care. She was like, can you see the board? And I was like, nah. And she was like, I'll print it out. And I was like, this isn't big enough. And she was like, oh, okay. Still printed it out the same size. And I was like, okay.
I really wish that I had done physics for AS rather than biology.
I think I would have spoken out more in physics to be like, yo, can't see this, bro.
I think I would have been more willing to ask for help instead of, like in biology, giving up completely.
Same with me in chemistry. Like, I just, like, because... Like, my chemistry teacher didn't help me, and I was just kind of like, well, what's the point then if I'm not getting help?
I didn't ask for help, but I really didn't like my teacher at that point.
I didn't like my teacher at that point. I was she just didn't like me.
I don't think that I don't think it was that she didn't like me. I think it was that I was not putting the work in.
I was putting so much work into chemistry.
I wasn't trying too hard. But I did try, in fairness, with plants and blood, because I thought that was interesting. And then we moved on to... I actually don't know what else we learned, because I think that was the point whenever I stopped caring. But yeah, I think physics would have been a lot more exciting. And even if it was mathsy, like, I probably could have got through the maths by being like, it's physics, though.
This isn't maths.
This isn't maths. This is physics. I reckon I probably could have done it, but...
Geography, I think... I don't know. I think I just like the teachers, and then that's why I was, like, able to sort of go up and be like, yo, I don't get this.
Yeah, there was...
Although geography, a lot of it I got anyway. Like, if
the one time I was absolutely shamed in geography was talking about... What was it? Like, air humidity. Humidity percentages or something.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
I just didn't get it because he was doing like, right, raise your hand if you think this, raise your hand if you think this. And I was just kind of sitting there going, I genuinely don't have a clue. And I raised my hand at the right time because I was watching everyone else. But I think he could definitely see the absolute confusion on my face because he kind of went over and he was like, read the bit in the textbook. And if you still don't get it tomorrow, come speak to me. And I was like, I don't want to go speak to, I don't want one-to-one talk. No, I'll read the textbook. I got this. And then I think I did get it, but... I was absolutely mortified. I was like, I am the only person in this class that does not understand this. And I just, I don't know, I just couldn't get my head around it. But I think I did eventually get it.
Yeah.
But yeah. Fun times when you don't like confrontation or talking to teachers.
So I really wish I could just repeat school now, just like with the confidence I have.
Yeah.
I think I said this before, but like, I'd be a wee rip. I'd be a disaster.
I like to think I would be good in most classes apart from biology, but hopefully I wouldn't have done biology.
Yeah.
But even if I had done biology, I would have been like, you know what? I think I probably would have walked out. No, I don't think I would have. I definitely would not have the guts for that. I would sit there and just be like...
What was that sound meant to, like, emulate?
Boredom.
Oh, okay.
But I don't know, biology's kind of cool, but physics is definitely where it's at.
Yeah.
I could argue that I would definitely fight with BP and be like, I am doing geography. Geophysics is a thing. I am doing physics. Goodbye. And then I'd be like, look, I'm only doing it for 1 year. I believe in you.
I did enjoy English though.
English was good. Didn't really enjoy French.
Yeah. It was okay.
It was manageable, bearable. Mm-hmm. But then flipping head of French man was like, you're gonna fail. It's like, oh, cheers, thanks for the vote of confidence there. Great.
I don't know why you're doing this for A level. Yeah, I don't know why you're not dropping it at AS. And I was
in fairness, I did get like an E in French AS and a D in biology, and they were like, So are you dropping French? And I was like, no, I'm dropping biology. And they were like, really? Because you did better in biology. I was like, I am dropping biology.
My chemistry teacher didn't want to see me again.
Oh, civil. Nice. I think at one stage my biology teacher knew I wasn't coming back, so she was like, okay, Judith, well done. Good try. At one point I think she did come over and she was quite concerned that my grades had dropped so far, but I was just like, sorry.
I'll do better.
I can't even remember what I said, but I do remember her saying something along the lines of, what happened? I was just like, I don't even care anymore.
It's kind of like me.
Didn't say that out loud, but yeah. I was just like, oh, I don't know. I maybe didn't look at it enough. Something like that. Whatever. Don't do biology for AS kids, unless you're super into biology, in which case, you do you.
Don't tell the people what they should do for A-levels and stuff.
Yeah, no, that's what I mean.
Whatever you want. If you like the subject, you do it.
Yeah, but don't feel like you're bullied into it. If you don't feel like you're good enough to do it, and if your teacher has nothing more to say, then you'll love it. Don't do it.
As long as you manage to get into biology, just someone going, you'll love it. My chemistry, because they were like, yeah, you get to work with a concentrated hydrochloric acid. And I was like, I'm in.
I think I would have been good at biology if I had Mr. Layard again, because me and him got on pretty well. I was like, I liked him, and I was like, yeah, okay, I could do AS biology.
I thought I'd be okay if I had, because I had the same teacher for GCSE as I did for A-level, but no, just came in AS here, and she was just like...
A bear.
Yeah.
Rawr.
She wasn't my friend.
Oh, that's really sad.
I was like, you miss why? But the technician was my friend.
That's good.
She gave me extra splints to set stuff on fire.
That's my favourite thing.
The teacher was constantly like, everybody only gets one splint, or tell you what, split the splint with your table. And then the technician came in and was like, here you go, Chloe. And I was like,
thank you. Did she learn that at the start, or was it just because you're your brother's sister?
I can't remember. It wasn't exactly at the start, but it was at one point, and I was sitting, we were chatting away there, and she was like, so your big brother's Colin? And I was like, yeah. He did enjoy chemistry. I was like, he enjoyed setting fire to stuff and playing with all the chemicals. I'm like, I do too, but just, I'm not as brave as him in terms of like, just grabbing stuff and mixing it up. And then, I think it was like the next day or something, I had stuck something I shouldn't have in a Bunsen burner. I maybe a page or pen. Miss Butler came in with a couple of splints. I was like, here you go, that's maybe a bit safer.
I think it was more
don't set pens and stuff on fire, just set the splints on fire, look at the pretty flames.
Did she ever be like, try sprinkling some of this in it?
Yeah. We were doing like colour changes in the flames, and we had to like put different stuff in it and see like, oh yeah, that burns with a blue flame. And we sort of stuck it in, me and my partner Emma, we sort of stuck a bit in, and I was sort of like, we'll add a bit more. And Miss Broly was like, mix those two together.
Okay. Imagine your teacher came back and was just like, what are you doing?
Miss Broly told me to.
She would deny everything. She would be like, I tried to stop them.
I didn't. I said you could.
If I had Mr. Caldwell for GCSE in chemistry, I probably would have done it for AS.
I probably would have exploded the classroom.
He probably would have encouraged it.
Girls, what are you doing? I was just going to add this to this. All right, okay. Tell me what happens.
Okay. Sorry, I think there's chlorine in this. Oh, that would have been so class.
Everybody evacuating the building, just me and Mr. Caldwell, last ones out. So, what was the chemical equation for what you did?
he totally would have done that too. He would have been like, right, so what did you just create? You mixed this and this, so what did you make? Just like, hydrochloric acid and chlorine or something. I don't know. I was bad at chemistry. I wasn't bad at chemistry. I think I was quite good at chemistry. There was just a lot of equations.
And balancing equations and stuff like that.
Yeah, that confused me.
Yeah.
Until the week before the exam. Because I can't remember if she did revision classes or if that was before we went on study leave, but she went through it again, and I was like, I was sitting there and I was suddenly like, I see the light.
And she definitely saw the look of... I'm really bad at hiding my emotions and my thought process on my face. So I was like looking at the board, and then she said she did something, and I was like, oh. And she looked over and she was like, I'm seeing a few looks of sudden realization. And I was like, that's me. I get it, guys.
That was me in additional maths. We did like a revision class, and like Mr. Money was putting something on the board, and I was looking at it, and everyone was sort of like getting an answer or whatever, and I was like, Flip is 14.
Imagine you blurted that out like, that's 14, right?
I think I whispered 14, and Mr. Mooney looked at me and gave me the biggest smile, and I was like, I did it! Get it! Look at me! I'm a mathematician!
The excitement.
There was some points in maths, and I was literally just like, there were times when I was nearly in tears, and then whenever it clicked, I was just elated.
I didn't like my maths class. Like the people in my class, because I remember one time that we had a cover teacher. Mm-hmm. So we were all sitting in different seats, and I was sitting over at the corner, just quietly doing my work. And I was like, we've discussed this before, I was a really quiet, like timid child. And I could hear ones behind me like whispering, and they were throwing rubbers and stuff. I don't know if they were aimed at me. My paranoia says that yes, they were, but they could have just been chucking them across the classroom. And then the door closed, like the door opened, and then it was one of those doors and it caught on the latch, and then if there was like a gust of wind or whatever through the corridor, it slammed. And I jumped the height of myself, and everyone laughed at me, and I was like, oh my god. I nearly cried that day because I was like, oh, that's so embarrassing. I jumped, it was just the door closing. But I don't think, like, it's not like anyone took the mick out of me after. It was just kind of funny. Looking back, it was kind of funny. It was just the door line, but I jumped out of it. It was really quiet in the classroom too, like, it was really loud. I was so deep into my maths, I didn't know. Knee deep in simultaneous equations.
What? I'm gonna name that. That's the podcast name there.
What?
Knee deep in simultaneous equations.
If you put a simultaneous equation in front of me now, I wouldn't have a clue what to do with it. How do you do Pythagoras as well?
Like, I know there's a squared plus b squared equals c squared.
Oh, hold on, no, what's cos, cosine, and tan, cos?
That's the angle of inside a triangle.
I liked them. Can't remember how to do it, but I liked that.
Sin, cos, and tan, it like corresponded to the angles and then the sides.
No, you lost me. I would like to go back and teach myself.
Sakatua.
That's right, yeah.
Don't remember it.
Something about hypotenuse.
Oh, yeah.
Sine is whenever you have the opposite and the hypotenuse. Because it's you have an angle and a length, right? No?
Yeah.
So then, sine is opposite and hypotenuse. Ka.
Adjacent.
Cos, adjacent, and hypotenuse.
Yeah.
Toa is opposite. Tan and opposite and hypotenuse. No, because...
Opposite and adjacent.
Oh, yeah, because Oa. Yeah, got it. Sakatoa.
Like, this is a knowledgeable podcast
we
right now.
We are educating the nation.
Like, all six of you. It's funny how we thought of the same number, too.
Six is the number of imperfection.
Is it?
Yeah, because seven is the number of perfection in the Bible. And that's why the devil's number is 666, because it's so close to seven, but it's not. Which is really annoying, because six is quite a nice number.
It is.
Seven is just... Not a huge fan of the number 7, to be honest.
I like 13.
13 is nice.
That's 6 at 7. That's imperfect and perfect. Is that good?
Negative and a positive.
Make a negative.
Oh, disappointing.
I sad.
So does that mean if you add a negative to anything, it can't become... negative plus a negative is a positive, isn't it?
Yeah. Two wrongs don't make a right. Yeah, but in maths,
they do make a positive.
But yeah.
This has been a lot of school talk.
Yeah.
Didn't mean for that to happen, but there you go.
Sort of did. I mean, this podcast is sponsored by school. School? Go to it. You're never too cool for school.
This podcast is also brought to you by the Chocolate Milk Shot Advent Calendar. The Chocolate Milk Shot Advent Calendar. Get some calcium!
Coming to your stores within the next 16 years.
This podcast is also brought to you by Simultaneous Equations. Simultaneous Equations, what the flip are they?
Why are they here?
This podcast is also brought to you by...
You'll really love it. Don't listen to them, it's a lie. God, you will not love it unless they can tell you a proper reason as to why you'll love it, or that you're really great at it, or that you will love the topics. Don't just... You know what? Do what you want. I can't tell you how to live your life.
Just to tell you what, let's make this a wee bit Christmassy, right? Just a wee smidgen Christmassy.
Smidgen Christmas.
Right. Three gifts that will please anyone.
Oh, I have to pick them?
Yeah.
And they could go to anyone?
Yeah.
Right. See, this is hard now in these kind of, in the culture that we live in, because you can't pick chocolate, because is it vegan? Does it have oat milk in it? Does it have cow's milk? Is it vegetarian? Is chocolate vegetarian?
Yeah, it doesn't have
It doesn't have meat in it. It doesn't have vegetables in it.
I know what vegetarians are.
Chocolate-flavoured broccoli. Or broccoli-flavoured chocolate.
Ew,
no. I would go with some kind of sweets or chocolate. I personally think vegan chocolate tastes horrendous. But maybe I could just be trying the cheap brand. I am just trying the cheap brands, not gonna lie.
The cheap brands are the out-of-date brands.
Yeah. That. I would go chocolate or sweets, so that's one.
Okay.
Is it for boy or girl? Like, just literally
anyone.
I would go with some nice unisex socks, Christmas socks. And, or a hat.
Everybody needs hats.
A nice fluffy bubble hat, because guys can wear them too.
Yeah.
They're all quite boring presents, though. Maybe a board game.
Yeah.
Or a book. Maybe a book. What kind of budget are we talking?
I don't know. Like, say £20.
Yeah, okay. What would your three be?
Mine would be a wee light box, like this bad boy. One of them light boxes that you put letters on to spell a word. Or multiple words.
Excuse me, I burped.
A power bank to charge your device, because
that's good.
Phones always die. And I haven't thought of a third one. But the first two are pretty solid.
They are, yeah.
Maybe some gloves, or...
Gloves are good, because your hands always get really cold in winter.
Yeah. Gloves, or... Yeah, just sweets. Like, just go with veggie Percy's, and everybody's happy.
That is true. Veggie Percy's are the nicest out of the Percy Pig collection, I believe.
I haven't tried the... reduced sugar
Percy Pigs. Yeah, must try some of them if we see them. You're making me feel dizzy because you're sort of rocking back and forward.
I felt really dizzy during the week. There was one day and I was at the gym and I was like, I could literally be flying right now and like I wouldn't even know. Like it was just, whoo. And I hadn't even had that much caffeine.
I read a post on Facebook about how caffeine kills your pancreas and gives you diabetes. Like those kinds of energy drinks and stuff. And I was kind of like, I'm drinking the sugar-free version. Does that? And I have maybe one a day, half of one a day. Like, am I gonna die? And it's not like I'm sitting sedentary when I'm drinking it. Yeah. I think it's worse if you're drinking it, like, and you're at school or whatever, and you're just sitting in a classroom drinking it. Whereas I drink it
before. Yeah, because you're basically using it as pre-workout, and that's, like, scientifically proven to do good things. And
so I'm not gonna die.
No, you're not.
Guys, can you tweet me if you think I am gonna die? Because I am... kind of worried by this.
Like, so we drink like Monster Ultra, which is like a sugar-free version.
Yeah, and we have say one a day, 5 days a week, before the gym, or like just after it, as we're walking home, like as we're doing something active.
Yeah.
When we drink it,
like we take it after the gym because sometimes we're just kind of wrecked by the time we've showered and everything, and we're like, ugh. To walk to the bus and then walk home.
Yeah,
like,
so then you need a wee bit of something to sort of be like, you know what, the world is a bright and happy place. It's all going to be okay. And so, yeah. At @skit_twins on Twitter, let me know if you think I'm going to die from caffeine. I mean, I am going to die. Death is the ultimate destination for us all.
Memento mori.
Memento mori, which is Latin.
Latin. And you have to tweet me what it means in... Latin.
Yep. So let us know what memento mori means. We already know what it means, but we just want to make you do some research because we've given you enough education in this podcast. So you should be happy with that. Go and do your own research, kids.
Susan, I hope you're well. I hope you're driving safely and with your hands on the wheel.
Who else do we know specifically?
Les, lessons? I hope you're having a great day. It was your birthday during the week. I hope that the buzz hasn't...
Happy birthday!
I hope you still have some cake left. And if you do, eat that up quickly, because let me tell you, if the cream in that cake goes off, you will know all about it. It is stinking.
Mum got a cake for her birthday in September, and like, it didn't go out of date until like October. And we were like, oh, I will just leave it, because Mummy was away to Italy. So we were like, Mum was like, oh yeah, I'll just leave it until I get back from Italy. And then we put it somewhere, forgot about it, found it about 2 weeks ago, and it was honking.
Which is really annoying, because I was really buzzing to eat that cake.
It's a really good looking cake.
Like, it wasn't homemade, it was from a shop, but like, it looked, it was like one of those
light and fluffy.
Yeah, it was one of those angel cakes, and it was like pink on the bottom and white, like normal cake on the top, with like some wee light layer of like cream in the middle. And I was like, oh, I'm gonna have a bit of that. Because I tried to convince Mummy to open it before she left, and then I was like, no, you can't open it now, because it'll go off. And then she was like, okay, I'll save it whenever I get back. And the first 3 days that she was gone, I'm talking really fast. The first 3 days that she was gone, I was so hyped. I was like, I can't wait for Mummy to get home. I can have some of this cake. And then after that, I just forgot.
Yeah.
You know what we haven't had for a while, Chloe?
What?
Ice cream for dinner.
Yeah. We need to get some ice cream.
Yeah.
Should do that tomorrow.
Yeah. If it's on offer.
Yeah.
Are we going to lift him with Mum tomorrow? We should be able to.
Depends, yeah.
Oh, yes! Let's get ice cream for dinner. But also, it's nice to have proper dinner, but also ice cream for dinner, lads. Living the high life.
Yeah. Ice cream's good. Like, I don't think you can really go wrong with ice cream.
It has calcium in it.
Calcium!
Calcium! I was trying to harmonise.
Oh, okay, sorry. I don't think we should harmonise.
Okay.
Yeah, buddy!
Buddy the cat is Maffus. He's not actually massive, but he's a big grown-up cat now. It's weird because a year ago I could hold him in my hands.
And just like
he was a tiny little kitten. And now he's a big cat.
He was a tiny baby, and now he's a big boy.
He a big boy.
So's Fintan. Fintan's getting a big boy.
So's Sebastian.
And so's Sebastian. They're my nevus.
Your nevus.
It's funny because I say that, and that's actually French for nephews.
Nevu?
Yeah.
What's niece?
Niece.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, aunt is tante.
Yeah.
And uncle is oncle.
No, we will not use we will use oncle.
Because that's how you laugh whenever your uncle's around. What?
Because that is how you laugh when your uncle is around.
Yeah, because your uncles tell really bad jokes, so you go,
right now.
But then if you're French, it's more, you just gotta stick your teeth out and drop your jaw a wee bit.
What's German for auntie and uncle, do you know? Not really.
I know Schwester. Sister. Do you even know how to say brother? Frère is French.
Hermano and hermana is brother and
Spanish
sister.
Sounds
Spanish
sounds so beautiful.
It does, and that makes me really sad because I really liked Spanish, but just my teacher just didn't like me, so.
German family members.
Soy es ma hermano gemeta. See, I didn't got the accent, but that's sort of from French.
I had
such a good French accent by the end of A levels.
I really hope Julia from Germany is not listening to this.
Julia, we're real sorry if you are.
Mother is Mutter. Die Mutter. I don't know why I'm talking like this. I sound more Swedish. Ich habe einen Hausaufgaben.
What's this Hausaufgaben?
Hausaufgaben?
Yeah.
Homework. Bruder. Bruder is brother. Svester.
Svester.
Son is son.
So,
apparently. I don't know. It doesn't say how to pronounce it. Oh, hold on. I can listen to it. No, I can't. Okay. Nephew is nef. They're nef. Nefa. Nef.
Nef.
Nicht.
Nicht?
Nicht.
What's that mean?
Niece.
Huh.
Opa.
Oh, what's that?
Grandpa.
Oh.
That's cute. Oma. Grandpa.
Opa.
Grandma. Sorry.
Oh my gosh.
This is an American site, though, so I don't know how... I'm not saying that the
American... It's like American Germans.
American
Germans. Is that what you mean?
Yeah.
I don't know what English Germans do.
Can I...
What are you trying to do?
I'm trying to get it to play so I can hear it.
Oh, okay. Just use Google Translate. Other translating apps, things are probably available, but you know what? We're just going to go with Google because Google... Oh, what was that?
That's family members. Because I googled that. Let's see. What did we say? Nephew.
Nephew. Or was it not uncle? I even know anymore.
Neffa. Neffa.
Neffa.
Right, what's niece?
Say it with me, people. Neffa. That's Nichte. German for nephew.
Nichte.
Nichte.
Is niece.
Is niece.
Let's do grandpa.
We're supposed to be fighting uncle, but sorry. That's okay.
Opa.
Opa. Opa.
Right, uncle.
Opa. Opa.
Uncle.
Uncle. Wait, what's the Polish for lips? Guys, I don't know if you've heard this, but VeggieTales is an amazing show. You should definitely look it up on YouTube or maybe Netflix. It might be on Netflix, but also search up VeggieTales, Larry. What do you call it? Larry's lip song.
Usta.
Usta. It's a very good song.
And you told me the word for lips.
Usta. Yeah. That's the first
silly song. Silly songs with Larry. I
love
lips.
My lips.
I love my lips. Yeah. Silly songs with Larry. I love my lips.
That's the one and only Polish word I know.
Usta. So you'll go to Poland and be like, usta, usta, usta,
and they'll be like, why is she shouting lips, 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 lips? What a weirdo.
I want to do that. I want to learn a random word in. Excuse me, like in different languages, and then just go to that country and just start shouting, hamsters! Hamsters! Hamsters!
That would be really funny. I want to do that. And you should just learn a word a day in a different language. Surely
that would be
like,
it. Maybe that can be my New Year's resolution.
Then you can have 365 words. Yeah. Wait, no, it's 2020 a leap year, because then you only have 364.
So is there always 365 and sometimes 364?
Yeah,
because sometimes that confused me. I
maybe not. I don't know.
So not an extra day.
Oh yeah, no, it's 364, and then on a leap year there's 365. Because I'm a dork.
Are you sure? Is it not 365, and then sometimes there's 366?
No, I don't.
No, that doesn't sound right.
No,
that was
364 and a quarter days. That's what it is. That's how long a year is.
I've never been 100% sure on that, but thank you for clearing that up. Again, something for everyone. Education all the time. What does this podcast put under? Is there a category? Do we have it as comedy?
I think it's comedy.
We should definitely put it under education.
I love how I just convinced you. We should definitely put this under education. Like, she did it with a straight face too. Like,
have you listened to the educational content that we have spouted out of our mouths?
I don't think it's really been particularly educational. I think it's just been...
We taught them German. We taught them French. We taught them Polish. We have taught people geography. We have taught people maths. We taught them Sokotoa. That could be a life-changing...
We also taught them Pythagoras' theorem.
Pythagoras. They taught that in Thunderbirds too, though, to be fair.
We all know that A squared plus B squared equals C squared. And it's the same for E, F, and G. Mr. Tracy.
Well, back on planet Earth. That should keep you busy.
What films should we watch? What Christmas films?
Yeah.
Like, top three.
I've never seen The Nightmare Before Christmas. Apparently it's good. I don't know.
Apparently so is What a Wonderful Life. Americans love that.
Is that the black and white one?
Yeah. Not a fan of black and white stuff. Like, I can only see a wee bit and just, I like colour.
It's a bit slow. Do you know what I mean? Like, black and white films, they're a bit slow. Even the start of The Wizard of Oz, and I mean, The Wizard of Oz isn't a fantastic film anyway, but I mean, it does get better when there's colour added.
Yeah, I think songs add to every film too, though. I kind of want to go see Frozen 2.
Same. I mean, I didn't absolutely love Frozen 1, but I did Olaf.
No, I enjoyed Frozen, the initial one, right? But I didn't like the hype afterwards and the Let It Go being played everywhere. Like, that made me dislike it, but I like the film.
I like Olaf.
I like Olaf.
And also, Anna is me.
Yeah, same. Just a bit of a klutz.
And awkward.
She means well.
Like, that's what most people would say about me. Just, oh, she's like, she means well.
She does her best.
Chloe, what have you done? My best.
That's 100% my answer. I
didn't do that in karate.
That's what I was going to say. What are you doing?
My best.
Next time. Thursday.
What are you doing? My best, Dermot. My best. Okay?
Because he always comes over and he's like, what was that? My best. In that moment, that was my best. You can do better than that.
Okay.
Sometimes I feel like he has more like belief in me than I do. And I'm like, where do you get this confidence in me from? I need some. What is that?
It's a bus ticket.
Oh, I thought it was money.
So guess what date it's from?
The 16th of September.
I don't even know where. Where's the date on it?
Is there a date on it? Is the real question.
Cute! I got this on my birthday!
Is that why you saved it?
Must be.
What about this Iceland receipt?
What Iceland receipt?
This one right here. When do you think it's from? What do you think we got?
I'd say September. So it's fairly recent. Maybe October.
Store manager? I'm not sure where the... This is your quiz.
Okay.
The date is... not on it. I don't think there is a date. I don't think we went there on a date. You were served by Stephen though.
Top lad is Stephen.
Stephen was nice.
Hey Stephen, if you're listening.
Okay, so the price was £3.30. Oh, hold on. It was on the 23rd of the... Oh, wait, no, you were meant to guess, weren't you?
Yeah. What? 23rd of September.
Yeah. At what time?
I don't know, it'll either be 12 or 4.
No.
12.
It was 5 past 5. And we got dime.
Oh, did we? I remember
did
that
we
day.
Get dime?
Do you want me to read it? Because I can read better than
you. Yeah. We got pink and white, so I got that much.
We got a chocolate assortment. We got...
chicken.
Deal Farm. We got Deal Farm milk. That must have been whenever Mummy and Daddy were away on holiday.
We got milk.
And pink and whites.
Oh, good days. Good days of shopping for milk.
Getting that calcium.
That sounded really scary.
Is that what the cow's going to sound like advert? Because...
No, the cow's going to sound really nice.
Oh, that's good.
The child is going to be like, hello, my name's Tommy. And then the cow's going to be like, hey, Tommy, have some milk.
What's the cow going to be called? But I can't be a guy cow, because guy cows don't give milk.
It's just... Okay, fair. The cow's gonna sound like... me. I'll be the cow.
Because you are a cow. I lied.
I'm laughing, but I'm also really hurt by that comment.
I'm sorry.
Are you really?
I am, indeed. Very sorry. Terribly sorry. Wonderfully sorry.
Wonderfully sorry.
Wonderfully sorry.
Okay, so I'm going to be the cow.
Okay.
So the cow's going to sound like me. Wait, it's 1704 on the 20... Oh, it's the 24th region.
Why?
I was going to say it's the same date as we bought the things in Iceland, but it's not because it was the 22nd or the 23rd at 1704. But, I mean, same time. It's at the bottom.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, it is.
Yeah.
So it is.
Hi.
Fantastic.
It is fantastic. Chloe, have you got any closing comments?
Any closing comments? Shut.
Very good.
What? What were you expecting?
I don't know. I don't know what I was expecting, but that... It didn't surprise me.
I've got it.
It really didn't surprise me. I hope you've enjoyed the podcast. Do get in touch. Let me know if you think I'll die. Let us know what if I'll die from caffeine, because we know that we're all gonna die. We've all accepted that. If you haven't, you really need to think long and hard about this.
Yeah.
No one's gonna survive forever. Not in this day and age. Maybe your grandchildren.
I mean, you might survive forever if the Lord doth cometh.
I mean, that is true.
From the clouds.
That is true.
In all his glory.
But then do we still get, like, heavenly bodies?
May I don't know, I'm not a minister.
Okay, I must
go ask Redkey.
Must ask Redkey.
You know whenever Jesus comes back.
I didn't do much.
Which, in actual fact, could be right now. Looks around expectantly. No, okay. Back to my question.
You'll hear the trumpets first.
Oh, yeah.
Imagine you said that.
I would actually probably pee myself.
That's what I was going to say. My guts would drop.
It would happen. I genuinely would. I would just be...
But, like, would you... Like, would it be a case of you hear the trumpets and suddenly, boom, you're gone? Or would it be like you hear the trumpets and you're like,
oh my gosh, what's happening?
And then...
Does he not have to divide everyone? Would that not be done on Earth?
Does that not happen? Like, I thought
what
it was just
would it
like...
happen? We don't believe in purgatory.
No, but I always thought it was sort of like...
At the gates.
No, like the good people, the Christians, the sheep, will just like start floating. Or, like, just be vaporised. Not vaporised, but you know what I mean?
I always
like, just
used to think
gone.
That it was, like, picking a team. Like, you're in Satan's team. You're in my team.
No, but they don't get to be put in Satan's team. Do they not have a chance to try and do better? No. Is that purgatory?
Because the Lord will come again to
make final judgment?
Yeah, to judge the living and the dead.
Oh, okay.
Like, I don't think...
Wait, so
like...
if he's there to judge the living and the dead, are the dead lying in purgatory? No, wait, no, because God exists outside time.
Yeah.
That still blows my mind.
Does that mean, like, technically they're just lying in the... Let's just not talk about this in the podcast, because no one can answer us right now. We're just asking questions here that nobody can answer.
It's a good philosophical debate.
If you're a minister, if you've done philosophy and all that crap...
Actually, no, don't tweet us. The answer's probably too long. Email us. Yeah. skit.twins@gmail.com.
I hope we covered all the topics that we were sent.
Were we sent topics?
I was sent glass as a topic from Susan.
You sent glass?
Susan.
Oh, hold on. I have two Twitter notifications here.
Okay.
Let's.
I'm going to go chuck this stuff in the bin real quick.
I'm just going to keep talking here as I go from my own personal account onto the actual Skit Twins Twitter account.
Okay.
Susan, you're here. I could use some Christmas decorating tips for a tropical environment.
Just tinsel everything.
Yeah, I'd say tinsel.
Wait, no, do you have tinsel in America?
They call it something different.
Garland.
Garland. Sparkly garland. I would say fairy lights are a good bet.
Fairy lights and then...
Fake snow. But it's a real mess to clean up. Like, that's a big undertaking. I would not... Yeah. I wouldn't go for fake snow.
Those, like, make paper snowflakes?
Yeah. Like an elf.
Oh, right, yeah. I thought you said, like, an elf,
like,
and I was
like
elves
in the
don't
movie,
do that.
Like, in the movie, elf. Yeah, I think fairy lights is always a good bet.
Yeah.
Fairy lights everywhere. But, like, only switch them on at night. Like, don't have them on all the time.
Yeah, like, conserve energy, guys. We're trying to save a planet here.
Yeah. And if you can get LED ones, because they use less.
They're more energy efficient.
Yeah. Yeah, and tinsel. But also, you know those wee, like, Hawaiian necklaces that they give you with the flowers?
Uh-huh.
I think they would look pretty cool. But then maybe that's going too tropical.
Yeah. But then that's not really Christmassy, though.
Yeah, I know, but I think they would... You could put those around your Christmas tree instead of tinsel.
Well, yeah. But, I mean, I was thinking more they probably wouldn't have a Christmas tree, they'd just have a palm tree.
Okay, right, so I'm going to tweet Susan some of these ideas and then she can listen back. So... Decorate a palm tree.
Fakes no, if you can be bothered to cover up, but also you could just use paper or like something white to like symbolize snow.
Yeah.
Maybe
she could invest in a white carpet.
A sandman instead of a snowman.
Okay, right. A sandman.
Complete with scarf and stick arms.
Snowman.
And a carrot nose, because then you could eat it at the end of the day, because the sun will cook it during the day.
I'll just say with scarf, sticks, and carrot. Fairy lights everywhere.
Yeah.
Those wee Hawaiian... I can't spell Hawaiian.
Hawaii. Spell Hawaii. And then add an A-M.
And... Flower necklaces as tinsel. No, what do we say? Garland.
Yeah, well, I'm sure she'll know what tinsel is. She can Google it if she doesn't know what it is.
Yeah. What else did we have? We had another... Did we have any other ideas?
You could hang presents everywhere. Just play some good Christmas music. Like, that's really all you need. And just, like, a loving, warm, homely feel.
Oh, that's really cute.
Light some scented candles and get that smell of cinnamon everywhere.
Also, if you get Santa decorations, throw some sunglasses on them.
Yeah.
Santa and sunglasses is always, like, Christmas in a tropical climate. Like, that's just it.
A reindeer sunbathing.
Barbecue on the beach.
A reindeer sunbathing. A reindeer on a barbecue.
Barbecued reindeer. Is that not what we meant?
Yeah, no, that's what I was going for, but okay. Then I'm kind of thinking about it and going, that's a wee bit mean. Like, poor Rudolph.
Who said it has to be Rudolph? It could be
Donner and Comet. Blitzen. Like, they all deserve it. They called
her names.
Like,
we do not condone payback.
Don't kill reindeer. He who is without sin cast the first stone.
Guys, also
or
go on
to the first barbecue.
Yeah, guys, go on to iTunes and listen to Simon Mayo's Confessions podcast. There's no new episodes, but the old ones are great. Then I want you to tweet Simon Mayo and ask him, please, nicely. Ask him nicely. Don't bully him. Just ask him, please, nicely, to do more Confessions podcasts, please, and thank you.
He's getting the people to.
Yeah. I don't want to do it. I don't want him to not like me. I need other people to do it.
Some little bit of a dictatorship thing going on there.
I'm not forcing them to do it. I'm just asking them nicely.
Yeah. Delegating.
Like, there's nothing bad will happen to you if you don't do it, but I would really appreciate it if you did.
Yeah, fair.
Susan, I hope that helped. I hope that you'll be able to send us pictures of your beautifully decorated tropical Christmassy home. Yeah. That's us now.
Please never use that word. I don't like it. It's overused. It's just stupid.
I didn't mean nay. I meant now.
Now. That's just nay.
Like, whenever I said it to some Welsh people and they got really confused, and I just...
Is that use away on now?
Oh, I will never be able to think of that phrase again. Is that use away on now means, are you going now?
Yeah. Is that use now? Is that use finished up? Is that you ready?
Yeah.
And some people don't get that. That's our wee Northern Irish phrase of the week.
Yeah, you're welcome. Keeping up the thing.
It's, we didn't really do any of our theme, not themes, segments.
What do we normally do?
The Google game.
Game we didn't know. Well, we kind of did. We looked up German words.
True. Because that's now, like, over an hour, so I think we'll just leave it there, will we?
This is a bumper edition.
It's not really.
Educational podcast.
Yeah, go pee. Keep. Bowel movements, I'm just gonna stop. If you can be anything, be kind.
Put clothes on.